Tom Mannion. They lead by one. They were five down at half time. Diarmuid Connolly has missed several in the second half, but he doesn't miss from there.
Oh, what a score by Connolly. That is a match winner if there was ever one.
I would have went down, obviously, to St Vincents, probably 4 or 5 years of age. Obviously went to the schools down in Marino then, school were in Marino, obviously a very traditional GAA school. We won a couple of coming of months goal titles with them, and then probably progressed then up in through the underage ranks with St Vincent's then, and then into Arscariche obviously afterwards, and played 14 and 16 with them, then transitioned into minor and 21 with Dublin, and obviously here I am now today. My father's from Kilkenny, so a lot of hurling was played growing up, obviously. I played all the way up. I played 21 with Dublin, and obviously then kind of made the choice after that. So I played minor at 21 for Dublin with the hurling as well. I probably much more hurling than I do football. Obviously we do a lot of analysing of other teams and stuff like that, which kind of doesn't taste the enjoyment out of it a little bit. But I love watching hurling. Like, I went to most of the games anyway. Watched Dublin, obviously followed them, and obviously Kilkenny as well. Hair standing up in the back of your neck kind of thing, you know, championship days in Croke Park, running out, you know, 80,000 people screaming, you know, the noise, the heat. I think we went to league this year unbeaten. We've obviously won the Leinster Championship. Like, there's obviously massive competition for places, and people are going to be disappointed, obviously, you don't get the jersey, but we're young, fit men, we're aspiring to be the best we can be kind of thing, you know, so the competition obviously is there, and you know, the talent is there. And I think the work ethic is there, and that's probably the main aspect of it, really. He's an absolute gent. Jim, obviously his persona in the media is a little bit kind of, you know, a little bit taken aback or whatever. But no, just great coaches, absolutely brilliant coaches. He's great ideas. Just trying to add layers to our game every season, every kind of National League, Auburn Cup, Championship. But then you've got the likes of Jason Sherlock, Dec Darcy, Mick Deegan, and their experience obviously of the game, and how good coaches they are as well. Like, you know, it all kind of adds up, and they dovetail really well together, you know. You want to be the most rounded player you can be, you know. It's I've played anywhere in the forwards, even at midfield and stuff like that, so it's kind of, you know your role when you're going out to play. Obviously different positions, you need different attributes, obviously, you know. So it's just trying to keep fit, you know, strong and fast. That's basically all you're trying to be, like, you know. And then you've got your role then, wherever you're playing, may wing forward or full forward or centre forward. Obviously you have a different role then, so, you know, just getting that done.